So today we will go in the next portion for introduction to signals and systems, which is left. One is known as Paley-Wiener criterion and the second is about the stability. So whenever we are saying like this, Paley-Wiener criterion. Let us first write the expression for Paley-Wiener criterion. So this is the expression actually for Paley-Wiener criterion. The Paley-Wiener criterion is telling that the frequency, that the modulus of frequency response for the or the amplitude response. You can see over here the modulus of amplitude response. You can see over here the modulus of frequency response. So as per this Paley-Wiener criterion, the modulus of frequency response or the amplitude response is an even function of frequency. It will be an even function of frequency, whereas the phase angle, that is the phase response, is an odd function. So this is a very important thing. That means frequency response or amplitude response even function of frequency and side by side the phase angle of frequency. So the Paley-Wiener criterion states what it actually states. It actually states that a necessary and sufficient condition for amplitude response or frequency response that can be realized. That means these are the necessary and sufficient conditions for amplitude response as well as frequency response. So requirement of the amplitude response, that means what will be the requirement for amplitude response. Now we have to just justify. There will be three requirements for this amplitude response, and we have to justify those three. The first one is the magnitude. The magnitude of this amplitude response of a realizable network, the network which can be realized in real-time world, can be zero at a discrete set of frequencies. That means this amplitude or the magnitude of this amplitude response, you can say this value. This value will be zero in a realizable network for discrete set of frequencies. Clear? It will be realizable, it will be in a realizable network for discrete set of frequencies, but it cannot have zero magnitude over a finite band of frequencies. It can be zero for a discrete set of frequencies, but it cannot be zero over, cannot have zero magnitude over a finite band of frequencies. That means for finite band of frequencies, otherwise Pellegrino criterion is invalid. That is, if the magnitude of this realizable network will be zero over any finite band, so log of this thing will be infinity. If this thing will be zero, so log of zero, that will be in the Napier logarithm, it will be infinity over that particular band, and consequently h of j omega is unrealizable. The second one, according to the Pellegrino criterion, the amplitude function, that it means h of j omega in modulus, must not fall to zero faster than the exponential order. So this should not tend towards zero, which should not be faster than the exponential order. Clear? It should not be faster than the exponential order. Hence, any ideal filter is non-causal. What is the conclusion? Conclusion is, any ideal filter, which is the third condition, is non-causal. So this is actually Pellegrino criterion. So if the Pellegrino criterion is satisfied, then an exact synthesis can be accomplished theoretically with a finite time delay. If the Pellegrino criterion is not satisfied, then an exact synthesis requires an infinite time delay, not finite time delay, but an infinite time delay. But an approximation can be obtained with finite time delay. So that is the third condition, that it can be synthesized in a finite time delay, but if it is not satisfied, then it will be going for infinite time delay, but can be approximated in a finite time delay. Now, these are all for Pellegrino criterion. Let us come to the next point, which is stability. For stability, it can be told that the necessary and sufficient condition for a DSP system, that means digital signal processing system, to be stable is that the poles of the transfer function of H of Z, that means if H of Z is the transfer function, then poles of the transfer function H of Z, that means you can write it like this, P of I means this value for stability, and if this particular region if this is one, then this portion is the right hand side is the unstable region and left hand side is the stable region. As for stability, we are knowing this thing, this is the stable region. And this is the unstable region. So now we can say that if we have to check the stability for a filter, suppose a problem has been given to us, the question is, we have to check the stability of this. The question is given like this. Like this. So, how this can be written as how this transfer function will be a stable one? So, it's very easy to do. Just we have to factorize the denominator portion. Let the numerator portion as it is. Let us do the factorization for the denominator portion. So that P1 and P2 are the two poles that we will get over here. And now we have to see what will be P1 and P2. Of course, if this factorization if we will do, then as per Sridhar Acharya formula, suppose comma b2 if we are doing minus b, so it will be like this, plus minus under root b square minus 4ac, c is 0.5, that means half, divided by 2 into a. So ultimately it will be 1 plus minus under root 1 minus 4 into 1, 4, 4 into 0.5, that will be 2 only, divided by 2. So from here, if I will go forward, then it will be 1 plus minus minus 1 divided by 2. So I can write it like this, half of plus minus half of I or j, anything you can write. Just see, both of them are less than 1. So the value will be half plus minus half I or j, but this value will be less than 1. That means the system is a stable one. So now after that, this condition is coming, that bounded input, bounded output stability, which is the last portion. LTI system, which is known as BIBO stability. So whenever we are doing bounded input, bounded output stability for an LTI system or linear time invariant system, consider the convolution property that will relate the input and the output of an LTI system. It will be like this. Clear? So now we have to just find out. Sorry, this will be K. Now we have to find out just the amplitude or magnitude of this, and it should be like this. So first of all, we have to do it like this. This should be less than equal to this. This is the condition. Clear? Or we can write it like this. When m is there for all n, it will be like this. This will be the condition. And what is M? output is bounded if and only if the output that will be bounded if and only if this value is bounded, then the, of course, this is the amplitude, then only the output will be bounded. And if the system is also causal, then the output is bounded if and only if this is for causal. The output is bounded if it is bounded. So can say it like this. So these are the things, these are the sufficient condition for bounded input, bounded output stability. So thus the particular portion regarding LTI system is completed. We have checked it over here, linearity, number one, time invariance, number two, causality, number three, stability, number four. Of course, we can say that we checked over here Pellegrino criterion. That is all for an LTI system. Applicable to a DSP system. Thank you very much.